Hello again, everybody. It is a full weekend of coverage, and of course, it is tournament number two here in Ozark Mountain Country. Alex and I are on location here at the beautiful Ozarks National Course, a course designed by Core and Crenshaw. Players out here on a Sunday are enjoying their practice round, the final practice round before tournament play will get underway tomorrow. It is going to be a stacked field. We've had great coverage here, Alex, all weekend long with some great interviews for folks to enjoy right here on YouTube.
Oh, we have. And again, just to mention what you just said, what an absolutely beautiful venue this is. I mean, we've had a chance to talk with some of the golfers, and they've also noted, I mean, these guys get to play on golf courses all over the world. So for them to come somewhere like this and in every interview comment how beautiful it is, how just amazing the scenery is. I mean, look, just behind us here right now, I mean, just looking above us, you can see down in the background there, Payne's Valley, which is the brand new Tiger Woods golf course, the first ever public golf course designed by Tiger Woods that's going to be available to play very, very soon here. I think they've got preview holes
open. Matter
of
fact, next month is what we heard.
Yeah.
And of course, the big rumor mill right now in the golf world is whether or not Tiger is going to have a specialized tour between him and one other team, and I believe it is Justin Thomas, is that correct?
The rumor is Justin Thomas maybe coming here with a celebrity team, Tiger with a celebrity team, kind of a bit like the match with Phil and him, a similar thing to kind of launch the course. Again, it's kind of rumors right now on social media, but I mean, if that happens, it's going to be epic. I mean, it really is. But we're just standing here right now. Obviously, you guys can't see, but literally to my left shoulder here right now, Colin Montgomery is just walking off the 18th green after his practice round. Vijay Singh is actually just getting into the golf cart here to head out for his one as well. To see these amazing names and to see these amazing people is just phenomenal in this area. I mean, the last few years for golf in the Ozarks has become amazing. We didn't actually think we were going to be seeing these players coming back to the Ozarks.
And
they have.
Yes, and how can you not be a fan? Of course, I pointed off camera here, and of course, Vijay Singh pointed back. I mean, that right there, bucket list item, I think
guy.
You can call that. Also, too, we've got to get into the major news that actually just dropped. Of course, coming of age. The news broke. It has been the talk of all of the golf channels, all across national trades, and really the world. Phil Mickelson enters the Champions Tour for the very first time. And, of course, he had a choice to make. Where do I start? He is starting right here at Ozarks National. He's out on the course right now, getting his practice play in, and then he will step off his first tournament play on the Champions Tour starting tomorrow right here. That's huge news.
It is huge news. And in fact, we're expecting him to come heading into the 18th hole here in probably the next 20 or 30 minutes. He teed off pretty early this morning. Obviously, they're out there taking their time, just getting a feel for the course. I mean, Ozarks National is a beautiful course. It's nice and wide and open, but those fairways are pretty narrow, though. I mean, you don't realize till you're actually on them. I had the luck. Great opportunity to play this course just a few weeks back in a tournament for part of the Journey 2020, and it was an absolutely great experience, and you really feel like you can unleash the driver and go for it. But I tell you, if you don't hit that fairway, you are rolling off down a mountain. I mean, you can see behind us, this isn't just the view here, this is what you get on the whole golf course. It's stunning. And in fact, you know, you're hearing Tom Lehman and people like that on the putting green that we were just standing by just a second ago, talking to the caddies and to other golfers about what they thought. They thought it was going to be an easy course because it was nice and wide and open. And the first time they hit it, it was just, they said, this is a lot harder than you think it's going to be. So this is to have golf like this in our area, to be available to play for everyday people. This is not just a course that's private. This is not a members club. Johnny Morris and the Big Cedar team do not want to make their courses membership courses. This is for the public to come and play. So when you've got the caliber of these guys coming out and commenting on this, and the fact that we've got the opportunity here with the Gimme Cast to be out here today and for the rest of the week as well to visit with these golfers, we're hoping to get an interview tomorrow, or at least be part of the press conference with Phil Mickelson as well. I mean, to have Phil here is just an epic thing. Now, we were talking with some of the PGA touring press that go around with the tour all the year. They were kind of saying, obviously, Phil missing the cut on the last tournament and a little bit of a gap opening up before the next championship. He wanted to come in and get some practice and get sure he's getting on the holes and getting out on the greens and just making sure that he's smooth and ready for the next tournament coming up on the major PGA. We had an interesting interview, didn't we, earlier with Bernard Langer. He kind of mentioned the fact, you know, what do you feel about having somebody like Phil coming on the tour? Are some of the guys worried about him stepping up? And he actually turned around with a smirk on his face and he said, Maybe Phil should be a little bit worried because he says, you know, it's not an easy tour to be on, and some of these names are phenomenal golfers.
Yeah, I would say that Bernard was quoted as saying he better bring his A game. And so that is just that competitive spirit. Fun spirit of these players on the Champions Tour, pretty much in a subtle way calling out Phil Mickelson on his debut on the Champions Tour.
We got it on camera as well.
We did get it on camera. Yeah. You've got that here on YouTube as well. Just got to give a huge shout out to Shane Burch as well. Of course, first tournament play winner here in the Ozarks. And I will say this to you. I think the best way I can describe it is resilient. A lot of resiliency and just completely dominating the first tournament of action play here. And, of course, they were over at the Buffalo Ridge Springs course, and Shane had an absolutely picture-perfect performance. People are still talking about it going into Sunday and into the next tournament. So congratulations to Shane. And I think we would be remiss if we didn't say thank you to Scott Perrell and also Tom Pernice Jr. Those interviews will be coming up on the Gimme Cast podcast. Those guys are really class acts. And what backgrounds, what great storytellers.
Oh, just absolutely fantastic. I mean, we know to hear stories about, you know, not actually going to college to play golf and going into computer science and really just friends at the golf course telling you should be going pro and then just giving it a go and then being on the tour and making millions of dollars and getting to do this for a life. I mean, it's the stories that you hear your friends saying and you just know they're never going to do it. And then you actually hear a story like that. I mean, it's a Cinderella story, not to quote the famous movie, but it really is. It is one of those kind of stories where you just think this is just amazing. And to speak with them and to sort of see the determination. And I think when we asked, when we asked them about what their feeling was and what would they like to be remembered for, hearing them say, for being somebody who didn't give up. And who kept going
from start to finish,
and really just it's a real kind of inspiring stories and inspiring story to hear and just amazing, and for those guys to have taken the time to come on the Gimme Cast and to do that. I know you guys are going to love the interviews. We enjoyed the interview, and hope we're going to have a few more before the end of this tournament.
It's going to be a lot of fun. There's a lot of great golf action to come your way. Again, tournament play here at Ozarks National will get underway on Monday. It will go for 2 days, so Monday, Tuesday. Wrap up coming your way on Wednesday. We'll have more news updates. And again, Alex, we got to tell them, for everything that you want to know about the game of golf, stay connected. You can only find it on Alex Webster Golf TV right here on YouTube. And also be sure to check us out and give us a follow on Instagram. We are easy to find.
Exactly. And if you want to make sure that you are getting every brand new episode of the Gimme Cast, weekly episodes coming out, we want to make sure you're doing that. Get yourselves on to Spotify right now. It will be available on all podcast formats very, very soon. But Spotify, go on there, subscribe to the Gimme Cast. And honestly, not only are you going to get golf information, we're talking products, we're talking everything about golf that between the two of us and our fantastic guests. But you know what? We're having a lot of fun doing it as well. And that's something that we want to make sure people realize, that we are having fun. It's entertaining. Even if you don't like golf, I promise you're going to have a laugh with it. So make sure you go on to Spotify, give the Gimme Cast a follow, and we'd appreciate it, wouldn't we?
Until we see you next time, we are live here at Ozarks National. Friends, we would just encourage you to play healthy and enjoy the game.